Hi everybody, Jan here from Jan's Art. I'm going to paint this lovely little farm scene with the farm building. It was up in Beamish when I was there the other day doing some plein air painting, and I had to cancel it because of the weather, so I thought I'd give it another go. I was going to do this originally in oils, but I've changed my mind. I want to have a go in acrylics because that's how I wanted to do it on the day when I first saw it. The reference is a photograph that I took when I was there trying to paint it. So let's see if we can get what we want on this canvas. It's a 50 by 70 centimetre canvas, so it's fairly big. I'm just going to concentrate on the sky at the minute, so I've got just a few colours. I've got white, cerulean blue, some violets and a black. So I want to concentrate on getting the clouds, the moody clouds that I saw on the day. Right. So let's start. Get my favourite brush. This is my favourite brush. It's just an old gesso brush. And it's going to give me the colours that I want, and it's great for blending and doing in clouds and skies. So first off, I'm just going to get some white, mix in the white on my stay wet palette. It's just a canvas, damp, with a bit of an old cloth underneath. Let's get some cerulean. Oh, that's nice. I like to make puddles. So when I'm doing something, there we go. Oh, I've got lovely greys there. Maybe put a bit of violet in, eh? Oh, that's a nice look. So I've got my cloud colours all ready. Put a little bit of liquid on me. There, right, so let's just get rid of that. Right, so I've got my colours ready. Get my brush, I'll dampen my brush. Get rid of the excess so it's nice and damp, but not wet. That's it. Now I'll just start and I'll just load my brush. There we go. I'm not ruining my colours. I can just pull in some more colours. Just dry brushing, look, it's going on lovely. I can still see me rough outline, which is what I want. Let's just put some colour in here. Now it wasn't a blue sky, it was overcast, so that's what I want to do. Just want to overcast. Get some. There we go. Now the whites between the trees, I might as well put them in now. And it's easy to do when I come to do the trees. Okay, so I'm just putting in this. Let's bring some overcasting over here. Look. Ooh, that's nice. Look. When you dry brush, you can really make up sublime clouds. It really is. There we go, that could be lovely. Wet it a little bit more, get rid of some of the excess. That's it, it'll go a little bit further this time. It's transparent, so my outline that I've sketched with a permanent pen will always be visible. I can cover it up slightly. but I want to be able to see it when I come to paint it. Okay, let's get some of this blue over here. A bit more cerulean in the white. That's it. Just dry brushing it in. More cerulean, maybe a touch of violet. Oh, that's a lovely colour, look. That's it. I just want to make a mood in the sky. So it's not a beautiful blue sky, it wasn't. It was windy. Goes over the outline. You won't paint the line, there's nothing worse. I'm going to be doing trees. So. That's it, it's quite a big canvas. I'm going to try using a bigger brush. There we go. Right, let's see what we can do with this brush. Okay, see if we get a bit more coverage. Oh, yes. I'm going in crosses when I'm painting. It blends in lovely. There we go. So you can get some atmosphere going on. Right, let's just add violet, yeah. Oh, look at that. Okay. A bit of depth. That's it. Oh, that's lovely. So I can get that bluey depth. Right, let's put some cerulean into this violet. I'm going to highlight some of these clouds, so I'm just putting, give me a hand of rest, using my other hand. That's it. So I've got some violet on the right and some cerulean on the left, a little bit more cerulean maybe, there we go, just in the corner. That's it, go over your trees. Something. Brilliant. Maybe a little something coming along here, especially on the horizon. Find the sky for you. Right. ride. I'm just highlighting the sky. Pushing that violet back a little bit. Maybe bringing it in back here and there. Work on these clouds just to make them a little bit more interesting. You can just barely make them out. That's what I want. Let's bring some of this overcast back in over here. So everything's happening in the sky. Now the edges of the trees, I just want to highlight them, so I'll put some white in. Just along the boundary of the trees. I can still see the outline where I need to put the trees in. Just looking for spots on the canvas where I can just blend it in a bit better. Now I'm starting to get some depth to my sky, which is what I wanted. Just playing with these four colours. If you can do random clouds, it looks so much better than contrived. If you use your other hand to paint with, then you go random, I guarantee it. I'm right-handed, but if I want, I can just put in my left hand. And it's not as controllable as my right, and I can get that randomness that I want. This is coming on just lovely. I'm just going across, just giving it a right where this tree line is here. I just want to make it a little bit lighter, so I'm going in with the whites. Around the trees. That's it. Maybe put some colour in the middle, because I can build that up with a sponge or a fan brush as I see fit. But at the moment I'm just concentrating on my sky. And I'm dry brushing, and it's going on lovely. And as I put it on, it's dry. It's called dry brushing, isn't it? Okay. So we're getting some lovely colours in this sky. On the top here. That's it. Right, let's just work on this overcast. If you bring a few little darks. Oh, that's lovely. I'm just working with a grey. Nice black. Oh, that's lovely. Nice little. Like it's a far bank of darkness. Something, that's the rain coming in, you see. That's what ruined me plein air painting. So I might as well get me one back. It's mainly on this side that I want to do it. So there we go, I've got a bit of movement in my sky. And let's get some white. And let's just define some layers in the sky. Look. That's it. Oh, that's lovely. I love skies. Right. How are we getting on? Bit of whiteness going on in here. I'm using my big brush, so let's just around the trace along the horizon, see? Just pure white. Blending in lovely with the sky. Oh yes. Now if I get the corner of the brush and just put it in white, see, just a corner, I can just work in a little bit of white where I want it. On this side, you see. Maybe this is a nice day going away, and this is the overcast day coming in, you see. Right, I think I'm pretty much done on the sky. So I'm going to let that dry, and then we'll come back and we'll start doing this central tree. I think what I will do though, with just a little brush, a little flat brush, it's just, oh look, this is better, look. Hey, something happening up there, look. See, maybe it's a cloud, it's just losing its integrity with the overcast. Look at that. Over here, look. Just random white. That's it. It just gives a bit of upper depth, doesn't it? Oh, that's nice. Let's do some more there, look. That's it. Let's just bring. Right, let's start doing some of these trees inside. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some black, just make a puddle of black, get some umber in there, some burnt umber with the black. Okay. And this will be my dark colours. Right, and I'm just using a little bit of cadmium yellow deep hue just to give me some of these nice browns. There we go, see? So I'm using three colours there: black, burnt umber, and cadmium yellow deep hue. Okay, so I've got a fern brush. Let's just wet my fern brush. And let's go in with some of the dark side first. Right, I've got my outline of me. So I'll just really want to go above the outline, and that's it. Oh, there's my dogs barking. What on earth do they want? It's coming in. Best alarm system going. Alright, so I'm just going to go in and maybe bring some of these. The fan brush can give you loads of randomness. That's it. Just jiggle it and wiggle it. There we go. So we get some darks in. I'm going to add a little bit more black just to make it a little bit darker. Some more in, leave some white, some sky. Okay, let's just put some dollops. Well, it's going to be solid colour. That's it, see? Let's bring it down to the roof. Just along the roof. Where were we? On this tree. Okay. Let's put some darks in. Make sure I leave plenty of light coming through the branches. Some more of this black coming around the barn here, look. That's it. Right, let's change that brush. Let's get a full bear. That's it. Nice full bear. Got like a rounded flat edge, and I can start putting in some of these really dark darks. Okay. This is the heart of the second tree that I'm putting in. So I'm just putting in some darks. There's not much light going through it until you get near the top. Just get some darkness in there. Right, I just want to add some randomness, even a little bit of lights. That's it. Get me fan brush. Let's try a smaller fan brush. They're fun. Oh yes, this is nice look. If you hold it at an angle, I find you can get really nice trees going on. Just get these darks in. And then when I go over with a lighter colour, a green or an orange or a yellow ochre, it looks so much better. There we go. Now another way you can help these trees along is if you get a sponge. So I've got some sponges already here, just raw sponge, squeeze out the excess and just dip it in there, and that's it, look at that, there we go, we can get some nice inner foliage going on. That's it. Let's bring some of this foliage down here. Get some of the brown in. That's it. Just if you put along with the pressure, it gives you a really nice, there we go, look, let's get some more of this black in, that's it, make it interesting, have plenty of light coming through, look. So you can already see we're getting a lovely bank of trees coming on, foliage, and I'll use that darkness, just clean my sponge so I can use it again. Right, let's just get a little bit more strength in the black. It just randomize some of this black in here, look, that's it, making sure I don't ruin my lights coming through. I want to use them. Okay, there we go, maybe a dollop of leaves coming down, look, see, you can make the leaves go wherever you want with a fan brush. That's it, There we go. Right, so we've got our dark shadow on that lovely little bit of background tree going on. Okay, I've lost me trunks, but I can bring them back. I'm not that concerned about it at the minute. But I've got a lovely underpainting of the shadows of the tree. Right, so we'll just let that dry a little bit and then I'll come back to it and see. I've done all the sky, so I don't need to lift it up a bit. Just little flicks, look, just lift it up. Some on this side. That's it. Little flicks up. That's it. Okay. So there we go. So we got a lovely little explosion of a couple of trees going on there. Right, I'm just going to let that dry. Give it a minute to dry and then we'll come back to it. Okay, it's nice and dry. Well, it's dry. He said, taking some paint off. Right, I'm going to work my way around here, and for that I'm going to use cadmium yellow, deep hue. Okay, so I'm going to load it with my fan brush and just start to put in over the dark. Okay, and where I can, on top of the dock. Okay, right, see if I can zoom in on this so you can see what I'm doing. There we go. Right, so hopefully you can see how I'm just using the corner of the fan brush to build up some of these autumn foliage. And I'm just using the cadmium yellow and just going into little bouquets, little bouquet shapes, always on top of the dark. See? And it's really lovely how you can get like a 3D effect with just the two colours. See? paddy, pity paddy. There we go. And you can get some of that lovely autumn coming through on these trees, look, see? Just, I'm rotating the brush as I'm using it. I'll probably have to do this little bit here. But let's just do top of the roof. That's it. Doesn't matter if I go under the roof, because I can tidy that up when I do the tiles. Right, I've got a big clump of yellow here, big bouquet. So let's put that in. That's it. There. Can you see, if you do little bouquets, it gives you what you want. And you can go over to the other tree, look. I don't want too much because it's a different tree and a different colour. The yellow is on this tree, so I want to bring it in. That's it. Just on different bouquets. Excuse me, I've got a touch of the Theresa May's. Right. Okay, and let's just build some depth up just with my little fan brush. Okay. Now these fan brushes, They're nail art fan brushes, and they're really teeny weeny, and they're lovely for doing details. Because when you use a bigger fan brush, standard size fan brush, see the difference? I just like, it's all right the big one for doing a lot of trees, but I do like the little one. It can just be that, deal with all the minutia that make up this tree, you see. Let's just do a little bit more coming down here. There we go. I'm jabbing at it now, look. Try all different movements, it'll give you all different random effects. Then all of a sudden, this tree is starting to come alive. Now, if I go in and mix in between the cadmium yellow and the black and the umber that I had mixed, so I'm getting a darker, then I can just go in between some of the darks. Just to give me a little bit more choice in the colours. There we go. Now if you go too much, then you've got to come back with the blacks and the umbers. So then you get some more umber and quickly bring back what you lost. There. Problem solved. You see, I noticed I'd just overdone it with the yellow, so I'm bringing it back. There we go. That's how I get some of this. There we go. It's one tree nearly done. Clean your fan brush. I'm just going to go into some lemon yellow. Mix it with some of this cadmium yellow, so just so I get a lovely little highlight. Look at this, see this, where it's brighter. be on that top. See? Okay, that. See where the sun's catching it? There we go. Not everywhere, just in those few places. There we go, look. It's just highlighting maybe little places here and there. There we go. Going into the just keep turning it. Not everywhere, but just in a few little places, just to give the a bit more of the yellow, platinum yellow look. Oh, that's lovely, look, to the corners. It's your tree, so you can really make it any way you want. Right, let's just add a bouquet just here, just in the corner of the roof. That's it, look. There we go. Now we can start to get some background in. Let's add just a little touch of clean. Let's get some black in there, hey? Bit of umber. That's better. Now I just want to put in a just like a little star of darkness in there. Look. See? A little star of darkness there. That's these little stars of darkness. Let's carry on with these trees. I'm happy with that tree. I want to go into the next tree. So what I need to do is I need to introduce some of this green into me mix. That's it. Because I don't want it as golden as the other one. So this one is more green, so I'm using some sap green to bring it in. That's it. Just going over my yellow. There we go, so I get a different colour, you see? Right. Just finding my rag. Okay, right, let's start working on the next tree. So I'm using the little fan brush, so I'm going in with my greens, and all I want to do is bring in some of this tree, you see. There we go, look. Turn it when you use up the green, and I'm going into the, because these two trees cascade into one another, so let's bring this green. Now there's a lovely, what I call a bouquet of green just here, and it's just falling down on both sides, so let's get that bouquet in. It. There, so we've got a lovely bouquet going on there. We've got a few greens coming up here, a little bouquet up here. That's it. Now I can go into the yellow just to highlight some of these, you see, but not too much, just enough. There we go, look. highlight this book here, but it's still primarily green. Okay. There we go. Go back to my green, and let's just bring some of this green into the top parts. Now just go over the dark, don't let the dark be on the top. That's it. Just let the green. There we go, look. Find its own. There we go, that's looking nice. So come along here and we're going down, maybe a few little bits of green up there, look. Trying to preserve the white, the sky coming through. That's what I want to do. Now I've got browns, very dark browns here. So let's go into the umbers, just put some browns in. There we go, look, just a few little browns. That's it. This up. Put on that bit of black there. Have a bit of sky in there. It's not, there's no sky there, so I'll just mush it in. Because it's fairly dark in there, but there is a few little bits of something coming through from the darkness from that tray. See, let's zoom in on it so you can see what I'm doing. Just working on the black, that are the darks, and I'm just coming out of the edge of the tree. This is a green tree. It hasn't turned as much as the tree on the left. It has a little bit along here, look. So let's just put in, maybe this is where it's just catching the light, eh? Let's just bring this. There we go. A bit more. Let's try the lemon yellow, because that looks nice. Maybe the cadmium yellow. Oh, that's better. See? Just a hint of the tree on the left. Maybe this is maybe to do with position of the sun. When they begin to turn. That's it. Just a little bit. Let's bring some of this green and the umber back down here, look. Yeah. Oh, that's looking all right. Now I've got to fill in those bits that are a bit grey with either black. That's it. Bit of shadow underneath. There we go. It's like making a model tree on a train set. It's really loads and loads of fun doing these trees. And don't ever be afraid to have a go. Okay. Because you can have lots. There's a tree here, so I'm leaving this bit of triangle shape. Black in. Right, I've added a bit more black, so let's have some fun with this bit of umber in with the black and just little bits. Look, don't look crazy, just little bits. Strengthen it where it needs to be strengthened. Okay. Bit of light coming through on the bottom where that hedge is, which is fine. Okay. Right, we'll let that dry and we'll maybe touch up. He said, but you know what that means. I just can't leave it alone. Look, I want to put a bit of this yellow just on the top. Look, it's a bit of, there we go. Just little bits, look. Just highlighting. There we go. Just where the sun's catching it. There we go. Let's add some more of this green. Stick with the green because it's turning yellow. I don't want it though, I just want it primarily green. Okay. So I've left some. Just try and give some depth to these trees. Maybe tone down some of this yellow. That's it, look. That's better. So yellow. Let the green have a chance, see? There we go. Now we might as well start on this little tree here, so I'm going to go in with some green and black just to give me so I can make it out. So it's like a, there we go. Now that is a nice little tree. So I just want to put this dark in. I'll let this dry. That's it. Right, I do have a teeny weeny little pool on this side of the tree and I need to put it in. So let's get some umber. Sorry, some yellow ochre and white. Just to get that post. So I've got a lovely, that's it. Just maybe a touch of umber. That's it. Now, my tree's going to be there, so there is a pole just... coming down here. It's not the best telegraph pole that I've painted with a palette knife, so I'm going to go over with a very fine rigger. And when I say fine, this is just a couple of hairs on a brush. There we go. Let's try rigger number two. Tidy up some of the edges. There we go. And there's my telegraph pole. Right. I'm going to give it a bit of a highlight in the middle of it. You really need a steady hand. That's it. Okay, so there's my telegraph pole. Get my wee fan brush. Right. Now this green of this little tree here, it's like a slithery green. So I'm using the white and the sap green, and I'm making it very pale. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to that's it. A bit more white in it. That's it. Just seems to be very light green. So let's just work on this. This is a teeny weeny tree. But it's in the foreground of the big trees. So let's put that in there. Okay, there we go. And it joins, and it comes onto this telegraph pole, which is why I wanted to put it in the first place. Right, let's just add a bit of green. Over the pole at the bottom, cover it up. There we go. So we can see a distinct tree happening here. Bring some of this light back. Christmas tree, a birch tree or something. Don't quote me. a different colour, see? That's to a Christmas tree. Gotta push it out a bit. So let's just push it out a bit more. A little tree. All right. So just want to get these values just right. Right. What I want to add now is a bit of the trunk going through here because it's got some lovely spaces, which is begging, absolutely begging for some trees, trunks. See if we can get this done. Nice. So what we've got is we've got maybe something coming through there. That's it. Just enough. Make it interesting, see? Maybe it's got another branch just coming out here, look. Just going into that. That's it. I want to put in some slightly darker ones. So let's get some umber. Just make some darker ones. Okay, now these can just go inside the tree. See, just coming out wherever you see. You see these gaps? Just put in a couple. It just gives a lovely bit of depth to it. Look, see? Just drag them through. There we go. Now we can do this on this one here. Look, bring in a few little. Just pulls these bouquets together where you can just see maybe just a little one here and there, but it just makes all the difference. See, there we go. Maybe you see a light bit, don't be afraid, and just in the rigger. There we go. These are the little bits you can do to really enhance your foliage when you're painting trees. See a light bit, just put a little bit of a something in there so as if you can see through the tree. Just going to add some inner darkness to this tree. Give it a bit more depth. That's it. Thank you. That's it. So with just a few strokes, I've got my trees, my background trees, pretty much where I want them. Might just need a few. And I'm just drawing with a rigger now, look. I just don't care. Because it's going random and it's going to give me some of this randomness. But a bit of white canvas showing through there, so I'm covering on. Bit of random rigor. That's it. Better with the fan brush. Just being lazy. What happens? You get used to one brush and you're loath to let it go. Well, I am. Right, let's just pick up some of these greens. I like some of these greens. Always like to highlight just here and there. That's it. Right, I'm going to leave those trees alone for a moment. I think I just need to let them dry. I want to work on maybe this corner here. Right, I'm leaving it alone. I'm gonna let that dry.